Hey guys, it's Nicole. Welcome back to my channel. So today is a little bit of a different video, so please let me know if this is something that you would like to see in the future. So this is an empties video. So I'm not just sticking to like beauty or skincare or like a particular product. This is just products that I have used throughout, I would say, the month, and just letting you know my thoughts on them. So getting into it, it is a foundation. So yes, there is a bit still in there, but it's just impossible to get out. So this is the CoverGirl True Blend, what's it called? Hydrating Foundation. So to be honest, this foundation is something I have used for like, I wouldn't say like 20 years, but it's probably more. I just really like how this sits on my skin. It's not a super full coverage foundation. It is, I would say, more of a medium coverage. I just find that it suits my skin and my skin tone a lot. So will I repurchase this in the future? 100%. I actually have several bottles. When it's half price, like at Priceline or Coles or Woolworths, I will definitely pick up two different shades, one for when I'm not tanned and then one for when I'm tanned. So yeah, I really, really like that. The next product, super random, but this is just the Kohl's brand bleach. So I think this retails for about $1, $1.20, I think it is, where other bleach brands in Kohl's are literally like triple the price. So I actually find that this works so well. So this is exactly what I reach for when I want bleach. I use this mainly in our bathrooms and sometimes in our kitchen sink. Just if I feel like it needs a deeper clean, I will use this. But honestly, in my opinion, the Kohl's brand, they have like great products. So don't always just think because they're like a home brand, they're bad. Really recommend this. I think it's like exactly the same. I honestly can't tell the difference. Now this, the label did come off, but this was a Designer Brands Cosmetics Coconut Body Butter. Now, would I repurchase this? No, I wouldn't, because body butter, in my opinion, should be like a thick, ultra hydrating like moisturizer that seeps into your skin and makes your skin feel hydrated. Now, I never use body butter on my face. I don't know if other people do or not, but this I use more for my body. So arms, legs in particular, and yeah, and I find that this does not leave my skin feel hydrated at all. I feel like if my skin's super dry, it just doesn't absorb. It just like sits on my skin and feels greasy. And you know, I can put this on at night and wake up and just feel like no hydration has happened. So definitely, unfortunately, sorry DB Cosmetics, I would not buy your body butter at all again. The next product is this. So this is the Dove Summer Glow Medium to Dark Skin Gradual Self-Tanning Body Lotion. Now, I literally would only use this for like 10 years. This is something that, yeah, I just used if I needed to tan. Now, would I repurchase this? No. And that is because if you check out my channel, I've actually done a review not that long ago on the Kmart Anko Self-Tanning brand, Mousse. If you have literally been using like a moisturizer, try a mousse because it will change your life. Again, this like takes forever to dry. You feel super greasy. The smell, like you feel sticky and gross and just, yeah, it's not a great experience. So when I tried the mousse version of a self tan, I can't believe how quickly it dried. There's little to no smell, and it's like you've got nothing on in such a short amount of time. So yeah, goodbye moisturizing gradual fake tanners. I am all about that mousse life now. So no, I definitely wouldn't repurchase this or any other like moisturizing tans. The other products. So I have another Kohl's branded product. This is the Kohl's brand shaving foam. Of course, they sell this in Kohl's. I think that this is a fantastic product. Honestly, I don't really know what else to say about shaving cream or foam, but would I recommend? 100%. I think it does such a great job. My husband uses this predominantly, and I mean, we've repurchased this so many times, and yeah, no complaints at all. Really, like, if you're looking for a different shaving foam, check this out. Again, don't be afraid of the Kohl's brand. The next item is the Hourglass Caution Extreme Lash Mascara. Now, would I repurchase this? I actually don't think I would. Not saying that that won't change, because I go through stages with mascaras, to be honest. I just think that this is quite expensive, so that's why I wouldn't repurchase it. I'm actually super into the Lash Princess by Essence. I think that on my lashes is like, it does such an amazing job. So I would definitely be leaning more towards that, because price point. But if pricing isn't an issue and you do like a more natural looking lash that is long, then you will probably like this. So check it out. I also do have a separate video on my channel, so of course check that out. The next product is the CoverGirl Outlast Active Cooling Setting Mist. That's what it looks like there. Now, would I repurchase this? I think it did a great job at like setting my face. It didn't do a bad job, but I just don't think I would repurchase this. I personally don't like the sprayer. It feels like it's not wide enough. I know that sounds super weird and picky, but I like mists that go really far, like, and like a really fine mist as well, if you know what I mean. Like, I feel like this only got like little sections of my face instead of covering it really evenly. So yeah, again, I know that sounds super picky, but like, this is just my honest opinion. So no, I don't believe I would repurchase this. But yeah, not a bad product, but just not something that I personally am drawn to. So no. The next item is this shampoo and conditioner, which I do have a separate video on my channel. If it's not out, it will be out shortly. I tell you in the video my thoughts, so I'm actually gonna leave it there. Watch the video if you want to know if this is worth buying or not. You may be super surprised. And the last empty, which again, I have done a separate video on. This is just a sample size of the Sunday Riley CEO oil with turmeric. So yeah, as I said, there is a separate video on this. I might be starting like a sample series. Like, would I buy something from the sample I've tried? So yeah, I wanted to put this in there because I have finished it. So if you want to watch the video, a quick rundown is the smell of this is something that I really don't like whatsoever, but the product itself is really great. So would I purchase this? No, but that's only because of the smell, not because of the product. But definitely check out that video if you want to see more in depth about this. And yeah, that is everything that I have finished. As I said, if you want to see more of these videos, please leave a comment down below. I would love to hear from you guys. Thank you again for watching. I will see you in my next video very soon. Thank you. Bye.